Hey, Lynn dolls. So I'm here today to share with you all how I made some baby hairs on my Isis Collection Megan lace front wig. But before I go too far into the video, I just want to point out to you glam dolls, if you don't already know, Isis changed their name, and it probably has a lot to do with the political stuff that was going on. But the company Isis changed their name. Their new name is called Main Concept. So just in case if any of you might have was searching for them on Instagram or Facebook or on social media for that matter, and you kind of wasn't finding them, that's because they changed their name to Main Concept. However, this wig, which is Megan, is from their older wig line. So this is what the packaging looks like. And this is the wig Megan. That's the picture of the model that is on the packaging. And it's this wig on the packaging that I am wearing on my head. The wig does not come with baby hair. It doesn't come like that. So I was experimenting and gave it a try. Now what I use to actually slick down my baby hair is the Got To Be Glued hair gel that, you know, everybody and a mama has recently started using. So if you want to see how I created some baby hairs on this wig, and like I said, this is my first time ever doing it, then I suggest you keep watching the video, and I will see you all in another video again shortly. Later, dolls. So let's get started. Here's the picture of the model again on the packaging. That's the styling of the picture. And this is what the wig is looking like inside of its packaging. It is a gorgeous blue-black color. I am so obsessed with this wig. So I'm going to share some things I'll be using. First thing up is the Dermot Wig and Weave Neck Spray. I swear by this. I use nothing else. I've been using this for the past 15 plus years. It's a staple in my wig care. This is the Got To Be Ultra Glued Hair Styling Gel. This is what's going to slick down the baby hairs. And I also will be using my MAC Mineralized Skin Finish in a color called Medium Deep. I use this to help brighten up my parting space to make my parting space look more realistic. I will be using some hair clips to help hold the hair in place as I slick the baby hairs down and style it. This is also a wide tooth rat tail comb, and this is the hair razor. I love this one because it's foolproof, meaning you can't cut yourself, but you can chop off them baby hairs effortlessly easy. And I will be using a pair of tweezers just to help tweeze out the baby hairs and make it as dense as possible. So I'm ready to get started. This is the original parting space. I'm loving how it looks, so I'm gonna pretty much just leave it like it is. There's no manipulation needed on that parting space. However, this is what the inside of the wig is looking like. You have two combs on the top. You have the parting space, which is right there. You also have a comb that is in the nape of the neck, and the wig comes with adjustable straps on the side, so it can definitely fit securely on your head. I'm going to start out with my face powder, which is my MAC Mineralized Skin Finish, and I want to make the part as visible as possible. So I'm going to take the hair clip to secure the hair in its place to make sure there's no flyaways getting in the way. And then I'm going to take some of my face powder and watch this. Look at that. Look at that parting space come to life. OMG. This is what I love about using face powder. It gives a part a more realistic look. When you use like a cream concealer, it gives off a harsh look appearance, and it don't look as natural with cream concealer. So anyhow, I done placed the wig onto my head. That parting space is looking fantastic, and I'm going to go ahead and adjust the wig accordingly onto my head to make sure it's nice and secure. And then I'm gonna take the rat tail comb and part out a very thin strip of hair closest to the hairline as possible. Yes, dolls, a very thin strip. Then I'm gonna take the hair clip and pin the hair back just like what you're seeing. And this is how much hair that I decide to work with. I'm taking the tweezers, and I'm gonna do a lot of tweezing right here because that is too much hair to have for baby hair at this moment. So what I'm doing is tweezing and tweezing. That's a little bit of hair to show you what I'm doing. Do this a little bit at a time. Do not rush the process. Do not rush yourself. Take your time because, you know, once you do this, there's no going back. So I tweeze and this is how much I have left. And I'm going to take the styling razor and look how effortlessly easy it cuts the hair. That's how much hair that I was able to cut off. Now, the reason why I use the styling razor is because it gives it a more natural cut. When you use scissors, it gives too much of a blunt cut and it won't look realistic. So I'm going to continue that same process like I just showed you. I'm going to do that now on the side of my other hairline right there. Right there. I'm going to do the same process that I showed you. Make a thin part. Take the styling razor and just shade away the hair. So here's the Got to Be Ultra Glue. A little bit of this is going to go a long way. I'm going to place it onto the hairline like what you see I'm doing. Make sure I get it enough on there. And then I'm going to move into proceeding to try and make some baby hair. So I'm going to start out with a brush, a toothbrush that I will no longer use for my teeth. This will be made exclusively for just my hair. And as you see, I'm trying and it's not coming out like how I want it to at first. But that's okay though, because this is why I'm telling y'all, this is how you practice. So I'm going to go ahead and brush it down again. And then I'm going to take the rat tail comb and now it's starting to get into formation. The second part didn't form as good as the first, but that's okay though because I'm learning. See, and anyway, my bang is going to fall over it. Now, when I got to the other side, this side came out that much better. You see that? Look at that, effortlessly easy on the other side. So this is what it's looking like. Like I said, this was my first time ever creating some baby hairs. I think I did a pretty good job. So I'm just going to take my face powder and touch up right there on the parting space to make sure it blends into my forehead a little bit more better. Touch up that parting space and I'm going to fluff the hair out, you know, separate it with my hands, checking out that baby hair. It looks okay. I'm liking it. And I'm going to take my Dermot wig spray and here is where I'm just going to spray the hair to kind of give it its extra volume and body. I kid y'all not, I swear by this wig spray. It will be down in the info box below, so you can check down below for it. Plus it smells amazing. I've been using it for the past 15 plus years, but this is about it. All I gotta do is my makeup and this concludes the video. Thanks for taking the time to watch this video. Don't forget to stay connected and I will see you in another video. I am bringing you a full video going in detail showing you my little collection of things that I keep in here. Yes. But aside from that, that just concluded the video.